Dear students, very good morning to all of you. Welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. As we are discussing about the environmental laws, and we discussed two important laws related to the environment, that is Water Act and Air Act. Today we are going to discuss about the Environment Protection Act 1986. Environment, you all know, is in the very first lecture, if you watch it the same, we defined the environment in a broader perspective. Today we are going to define environment as per the law, as per the Environment Protection Act 1986. And as per Environment Protection Act 1986, the definition of environment includes air, water, land, and interrelationship that exist among and between them and human being and other living creatures and property. Means, as per the EPA, environment means it includes air, it includes water, it includes soil, and the interrelationship that exists in between them and with the human beings and other properties. So the environment means air, water, land interrelationship that exists among them, and the interrelationship such entities is having with our generation, that with human beings. Then environmental pollution. As we all know, pollution means any undesirable change in our environment. And here, pollution means presence of any solid, liquid or gaseous substance in such concentration or for such duration which may be or tend to be liable to cause injuries to human being, living organisms and property. Same is defined here, the presence of any solid, liquid or gaseous present in such concentration means the concentration must be to some extent that it results injuries to human being, living organisms and other properties, and or tend to be injurious to the environment, or the concentration of such chemical, be it in a solid, liquid or gaseous form, it must be in such amount, in such concentration, and must remain in the environment for such duration as it may cause injuries to living organisms and other living property, including human being. Then we have hazardous substances. Hazardous substance means any substance or profession by which of it is physico-chemical properties is liable to cause injuries to human being, other living organisms and including property. It may be of physical nature, it may be of chemical nature, and if such substance are being released into the atmosphere and by which of it is physical properties or chemical properties damages living creatures, human beings and property, then we can call all these substances as hazardous substances. As we all know, there are boats to function for protection and improving the quality of the abiotic or biotic components, be it Water Act or be it Air Act. But we have an important law which is known as EPA 1986. And EPA 1986, the powers of central government rather than center board, central government we are going to discuss. As per EPA 1986, the central government of our country has to take measures to protect and improve the quality of the environment, and what a government can take measures, what a government can take steps to protect and improve the quality of environment. First, power of the central government is to standard of quality of air, water, soil for various purposes. Means, what can be the quality of soil in any particular area if the same is being utilized for agricultural purposes? What can be the quality of the soil if it is being utilized for commercial purpose? What can be the quality of soil if it is being utilized for residential purpose? What can be the quality of the soil if it is being utilized for national parks and other biospheres, etc., etc.? Means different locations or different geographical areas have specified different standards of soil quality. Similarly, how much amount of pollutant may present in the air in a residential area, in a commercial area, in an industrial area, or in other areas. Similarly, the water quality has also been already fixed. What can be the quality of water? How much amount of pollutant can be present in a water which is utilized for industrial purposes? How much amount of pollutant load can be allowed if the water is being utilized for agriculture purpose? How much amount of pollutant we can allow to release in that water if the water is being utilized for public purpose or public distribution system? Means, be it air, be it water, or be it soil, different standards of different parameters have already been fixed by central government, depending upon whether for which purpose the air, water, or the soil is being used for. Then, maximum permissible limit of concentration of pollutants, including noise. As we already know, if any industrial operation is to set up in a particular area, before establishment of that industry, what happens? The industry is supposed to abide by the standards already fixed by the boards or the central government, as the case may be. So, before establishment of industry, the standards given to any particular industry is supposed to be abided by the particular industry, and to abide by the industry standards means how much amount of pollutant in the form of air pollutant, in the form of water pollutant, can be discharged by a particular industry is also in the domain of the central government. Means maximum permissible limit of concentration of various pollutants for different industries is also fixed by central government as per EPA 1986. Then there are substances which are hazardous in nature. As we already defined, what are hazardous substances, by which of it is physico-chemical properties, if it is liable to cause injuries to human being and other living creatures, then how to safeguard and what is the procedure for handling of such substance is, nobody directly handle hazardous substances. The person must have got a training how to handle such substances if accidentally releases at a particular period of time, and what is the procedure to handle such hazardous substances to avoid any explosion or any accident. And such safeguards and procedures are also laid down or guidelined by central government in EPA 1986. Similarly, prohibition or restriction of handling substance in different areas. As we have already bifurcated or segregated areas into a residential area, commercial area, industrial area, and silence zone. means you are supposed to use hazardous substance in such areas for which is it is specified for. For example, if any substance is supposed to use which is hazardous in nature, then such substance can't be utilized in industrial area, in commercial areas, in residential areas or in silent zone, but it can be utilized in industrial sector. So handling of such substance in the commercial areas, in residential areas or in silent zone is totally prohibited. The prohibition and restriction of any industry in a particular location, as we discussed it in the previous lecture, as per Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981 of Section 19, which declares a particular area as pollution free zone, we already discussed in the Air Act. So the central government also have the power to restrict or prohibit the establishment of industrial areas, industrial unit in such areas, for example, near to schools, near to institutions, near to mosque, near to masjid, near to temples, etc. Means such locations cannot be used for establishment of industrial operations. And prohibition and restriction of such operation in such areas is restricted by the central government. And procedure and safeguards for the prevention of accidents in case of any which may cause environmental pollution. Accidental explosions from a particular industry may occur. So how to handle if such accidents happen in a period of time? So already technical experts are being appointed there, and the procedure is already being laid down by the central government, and as per the procedure and safeguard, the technical team is supposed to handle such accidents by strictly following the already laid down procedures and safeguards for prevention of accidents, if any, which may cause injuries to living organism, creature, human being and property. And central government have the powers of entry and inspection for sampling. If the government think that any industry is discharging the amount of pollutants in excess to the permissible limit already given to the particular industry, then central government or any officer empowered by the central government having the right, having the power, is entrusted with powers by the central government, can inspect and entry to the particular industry for the purpose of sampling. As we have already discussed in the Water Act, while sampling, both the occupier or the industrial runner and the officer who is taking the sample, both should be present and both should sign, seal their signature, and such samples are sent to the environmental laboratories for actual analysis whether the industry is releasing the pollutants in excess amount above the permissible limit or not. Then under EPA 1986, SPCB have to follow the guidelines and schedules given by the central government. As central, there is a coordination between central government and state boards, as it is not necessary to act in a proper way by the central government on every geographical areas or the jurisdiction. So The coordination of state board has already been established with the central government, and what are the guidelines the state boards is supposed to follow? These are the guidelines the state boards have to follow. They have to advise the industry for treating the sewage. Sewage, the discharge is coming out from any industrial operation or from any industry. Before discharging such sewage into the nearest water bodies, the industry is supposed to give treatment to the particular sewage so that the amount of pollutant load can be minimized before pouring the effluents into the main water bodies. And SPCB is supposed to advise the industries for treating such sewage releasing from industries. They have to encourage the industries for biogas energy and reusable materials. Means SPCB is supposed to encourage the industries to reutilize the materials which can reduce the amount of energy for the industrial operations, and at the same time to switch over to such fuels like biogas, which releases less amount of pollutants in our environment. Both CPCB and SPCB have to focus on clean technology. Means there are outdated technologies which are being utilized in different industrial operations. So SPCB and CPCB is supposed to encourage the industries for cleaner technologies which is being advanced in present time. Simply, SPCB and CPCB is supposed to encourage the industries for cleaner and cleaner technologies, as the advancement of cleaner technology, new advancements are being available in our daily market. Under Water Act, it was amended in 1994, and in 1994 EIA was included. What does EIA means? EIA means before establishing any particular project, every industrial operation has to take a permission from the state board in the form of NOC, and is supposed to prepare an EIA report. EIA means Environment Impact Assessment. That if the project is being established, how much amount of social impacts, environment impacts, impacts on water bodies, impacts on biological diversity, impacts on air quality, impacts on employment generation, impact on pollution, etc., are being determined before the actual establishment of the project. And as per the amendment in 1984, EIA and NOC is to submit by any project proponent to the central government or the boards for the particular operation the industry is supposed to do. And under EPA 1986, central government also made waste management and handling rules 1989. Means now the rule has already been formed how to handle the rules, and if any injuries or casualties happen, how much amount of compensation may be given to the to particular persons. So proper guidelines has already been given as per the waste management and handling rules 1989. This was EPA 1986 as per the demand of the subject. So we discussed all the environmental laws, be it Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974, be it Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981, and today we discuss it, Environment Protection Act 1986. Hope you got some of the basics of the environmental laws. Stay home, stay safe. Till then, best of luck.